In this video, we hope to develop an intuition on some of the common latency numbers. They could be very useful in system design. It is not critical to know the exact numbers. Developing a sense of the relative orders of magnitude difference between these things is way more important. Some of these numbers, like disk seek time, have changed drastically as technology evolves, while others, like network latency between countries, stay pretty consistent because they have to obey the laws of physics. We updated some of these numbers to more closely reflect reality in the 2020s. But again, absolute accuracy is not the goal. Developing an intuition of the relative differences is. Here's what we plan to do. We'll group the latency numbers by order of magnitude, starting with sub-nanoseconds all the way up to seconds. To lay the groundwork, let's get a sense of what these time units are first. 1 nanosecond is 1 billionth of a second. 1 microsecond is 1 millionth of a second. 1 millisecond is 1 thousandth of a second. So here we go. Let's dive right in. At the top is the sub-nanosecond range. Accessing CPU registers is sub-nanosecond. It is super fast to access CPU registers, but there are very few of them. A clock cycle of a modern CPU is also in the sub-nanosecond range. In the 1 to 10 nanosecond range, we have L1 and L2 cache accesses. Some expensive CPU operations are also in this range. Something like a branch mispredict penalty could cost up to 20 CPU clock cycles, which is also in this range. The next range is 10 to 100 nanosecond. L3 cache access is usually at the fast end of this range. For a modern processor like the Apple M1, referencing main memory is at the slower end of this range. In other words, main memory access on a modern CPU is a few hundred times slower than the CPU register access. The next range is from 100 to 1,000 nanosecond, or 1 microsecond. The most useful thing to know in this range is the cost of a system call. On Linux, making a simple system call takes several hundred nanoseconds. And this is just the direct cost of the trap into the kernel and back. It does not account for the cost of executing the system calls themselves. And it takes about 200 nanoseconds to MD5 hash a 64-bit number. Next up, the 1 to 10 microsecond range. We've reached a level where things are about 1,000 times slower than a CPU register access. Context switching between Linux threads takes at least a few microseconds. This is about the best case scenario, though. Depending on the workload, if context switching involves bringing pages of data from memory for the new thread, it could take significantly longer. To put it in perspective, copying 64 kilobytes from one main memory location to another also takes a few microseconds. Next up is 10 to 100 microseconds. At this level, things are slow enough that we can start to include some higher level operations. A network proxy, the Nginx, would take about 50 microseconds to process a typical HTTP request. Reading 1 megabyte of data sequentially from main memory takes about 15 microseconds. The read latency of the SSD is in this range, taking about 100 microseconds to read an 8K page. The next range is 100 to 1,000 microseconds, or 1 millisecond. This range has some interesting things. The SSD write latency is about 10 times slower than the read latency, and it is at the top end of this range, taking closer to a millisecond to write a page. Intra-zone network round trip for modern cloud providers takes a few hundred microseconds. This is one of the numbers we updated for the 2020s. These days, they trend closer to the fast end, some even clocked in at less than 100 microseconds. A typical memcache or Redis GAT operation takes about 1 millisecond as measured by the client. This includes the network round trip mentioned above. Next up, 1 to 10 milliseconds. Inter-zone network round trip of the modern cloud is in this range. The seek time of the hard disk drive is about 5 milliseconds. It takes time to move the ARMs. The next range is 10 to 100 milliseconds. The network round trip between US East and West Coast or the US East Coast and Europe is in this range. So it's reading 1 gigabyte sequentially from main memory. There are several interesting things in the 100 to 1000 millisecond range. In one of our videos, we talk about using a slow hash function like bcrypt to encrypt a password. It takes 300 milliseconds to bcrypt a password. It is slow enough to render brute force password cracking ineffective. TLS handshake is typically in the 250 to 500 millisecond range. It adds several network round trips, so the number depends on the distance between the machines. The network round trip between the US West Coast and Singapore is in this range. Reading 1 gigabyte sequentially from an SSD is also in this range. Lastly, here's an example of something taking over a second. Transferring 1 gigabyte over the network within the same cloud region takes about 10 seconds. That's all about latency numbers. We hope you find them useful. If you would like to learn more about system design, check out our books and weekly newsletter. Please subscribe if you learn something new. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next time.